Let's begin.
Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about Excel rows and columns formulas. So let's dive in. First of all, let's explain what these formulas are. The rows formula will give you the number of rows in arrays of cells. For example, in this worksheet, if you parse the rates of these companies to the rows formula, it will tell you that there are 30 rows in that rates, so there are 30 companies. The columns formula will do the same, but for columns. Let's make an example. Write equal columns, parse this rectangular area, and it will tell you that there are two columns. It's useful if you have a named range, which is often changing. Also, you don't need helper columns like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Because with the use of rows and columns formulas, all of that can be automating. Let's say that you want to generate the number 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on in a set of cells. The easiest way to do this is to insert a new column, type 1 and 2, select them, and use the handler and drag it down. But what if you need such incremental values in formulas? Let's take an example to understand it better. I want to use the company names from column B and create the references in column E, but for the first 10 companies. For that, we can use the index formula and refer to the company names array, and use one for the first row to get the first value. To make the array range absolute, select it and press F4. And this also. The problem is that in the second cell, I need 2 instead of 1, and in the third cell, I need 3 instead of 2. So I can't do it if I have 1000 rows. So one alternative is to type the number in the helper column, which is the new column A we created, so that we can refer to the specific cells, instead of having to change the numbers manually in the formula. But we are using an extra column of values. Before editing the index, let's see how we can use the rows formula to generate increasing numbers and using them in another formula. Let's type here, equal rows D25 to D25. This formula is giving you a one cell range of D25 to D25. Now let's make the first part absolute and leave the second part as relative. Like this. As you draw the formula down, it will generate sequential numbers. The first portion of the range reference remains the same, as it's absolute, but the second portion increments by 1, as it is relative. With the same trick, I will use the rows formula here, like this. When we are typing rows, we have already seen that there is another formula called row. The row formula will tell you the row number of the current row, like this. Or you can type equal row D20, and it will tell you what the row number is. The same with column. These formulas are useful when you are doing some advanced lookups. Don't confuse it with the rows formula. I think the rows and columns formulas are powerful and are often used in dashboards. Even if it doesn't make much sense to you right now, bookmark the lesson and revisit it whenever you have a dashboard creation. Thank you, and I will see you in the next lesson. Bye!